Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have seen about PHP function and arrays, right? Hope you would have learned that. And in the functions we have seen function is a type of subroutine or a procedure in a program, right? Here we have seen about user defined and predefined functions. In that we have seen about function declaration and function calling, and then about the parameterized function. And then about the function arrays also we have seen. Array is a concept which stores more than one value of a same data type, right? In that we have seen about indexed arrays, associative array and multidimensional arrays, right? Today we are going to see about PHP conditional statements, okay? This conditional statements you have learned last year in grade 11 itself in control structure in JavaScript. Hope you remember the conditional statements which you have learned in JavaScript, right? That concept, that same concept only here we are going to see in this PHP also, okay? Only four concepts and small definition about the four concepts we are going to see in this topic. This is a very small lesson and a very easy lesson. If you listen to this class itself, you can answer all the questions which are coming from this chapter, okay? Let's move on to our subject. This lesson is PHP conditional statements. Okay, condition means what? It will have a condition. It may be a greater than or it may be a less than, some condition, and it will have an output as true or false, right? That is condition, right? Here PHP allows to write codes and to perform many different actions, right? So here, based on a test condition or based on the logic, we can get a result, and the result will be in the form of either true or false. Okay, for determining this, we have some statements. We have if statement, if else statement, if else if else statement, switch statement. This four statements only we are going to learn in this chapter. Okay, in the JavaScript conditional statements also we have learned the same if statement, if else statement, if else if else statement and switch case, right? Same concept only here also, but the format will be little different. When you see one example in PHP, you can write it by your own, right? First let's see what is if statement. Okay, if statement means one group of statements will be there and one specific condition will be there, right? If the condition is true, the statement will be executed. If the condition is false, nothing will happen. Okay, that is if statement. When you see the syntax, you can just understand. If, and then you have to give the condition. Okay, it may be A greater than B or A greater than 5. Whatever condition you have to give the test condition inside this bracket. Okay, if and then condition, and then you will have the statements. If that condition is true only, the statement will be executed. Okay, see this example they have given. Pass mark is equal to 35 and the student mark is 70, right? If the student mark is greater than or equal to pass mark, the student is eligible for the promotion. This will be displayed. Okay, whatever comes inside this echo will be displayed, right? In every languages we'll have some codes. Likewise in PHP, this echo is for getting the output, right? Whatever you give in this echo line, whatever is inside this double quotes will be displayed in the output page. Okay, here if this condition is true, then the output will be the student is eligible for the promotion. Okay, if the student mark which is given is greater than or equal to the pass mark, the output will be the student is eligible for the promotion. Okay, next we are going to see if else statement in this PHP. Okay, if else statement means same like if statement, we'll have a condition and it will execute a set of code. But here the small difference is, if the condition is true, one statement will be executed. If it is false, another statement, another set of code will be executed. Okay, see the syntax, then you will get a full idea about this. If this condition is there, right? If this condition is true, this first statement, if condition is true, this statement will be executed. Else, if that specific condition is false, then the next set of statement will be executor. Understood? See this example, then you will get a clear idea of this. Here they have given pass mark is equal to 35, student mark is 70. First we had only one condition and one statement, right? Here we will have, if the student mark is greater than or equal to pass mark, the output will be the student is eligible for the promotion. If that student mark is not greater than or equal to pass mark, then the output will be the student is not eligible for the promotion. Okay, understood? See, if the statement is true, the first set of statements will be executed. If this condition is true, the first set of statement will be executed. If that statement is false, then the next else part, we have a statement, right? In this else part, statement will be executed. Okay, here only true and false case is there. And the next one we are going to see, if else statement in this PHP. Okay, this is a combination of if else statement only. Okay, here we'll have multiple conditions. Okay, in this if else statement we gave one condition and we had one true statement and else statement, right? Here we can give more than one condition. Okay, first see the syntax. If condition one, first we are going to give a condition. If that condition is true, then this statement, first line, first set of statement is there, right? This statement will be executed. Then else if, and we'll give the next condition. If that condition is true, this statement will be, the second set of statement will be executed. If that is false, if both the conditions are false, else we'll get the output as statement if both the conditions are false. This third set of statement will be displayed. Understood? See this example. Here they have given pass mark is equal to 35. First class is 60. Student mark is 70. Okay. First in this if, same like that if else, here they have given student mark is greater than or equal to first class, the student is eligible for promotion with first class. This, like this they have given. In this, again they have given else if, and next another condition, student mark is greater than or equal to pass mark, the student is eligible for promotion. That means here they have given one condition as student mark is greater than or equal to first class, means the student is promoted with first class, like that they are displaying. And the next condition is, if the student has scored pass mark, the student is eligible for promotion. First it will check whether the mark is above the first class marks. If it is not there, then it will check for next condition. If it is if the mark is above first class, means the first set of statement will be executed and then the process will be stopped. If not, then it will go for the second condition. In the else if line, we have a line, right? Student mark greater than or equal to pass mark. If the student mark is greater than or equal to the pass mark, then the next set of statement, here they have given the student is eligible for promotion. This statement will be displayed, right? Or if you are giving some set of codes, that set of codes will be executed, okay? Or if both the conditions are false, then we'll get the output as, then the third set of statement, can you see there? The student is not eligible for the promotion. This else section, else part, we have a statement, right? This statement will be executed. Okay, understood? This if else statement. And the next last one is switch case. Okay, switch case means this is a alternative to this if else statement only. Okay, this executes a block of codes and it will have a match also. If you give one, if you have 7 days, you can give first case as 1 and you can display it as Monday. 2 Tuesday, 3 Wednesday, 4 Thursday. If you are giving in the switch case, first this is the syntax. See, switch of n, first you have to give the switch of n and then first case, and you have to give the code or the statement to be executed, and as soon as one case is completed, you have to give break, and then the next case 2, and then the next line, what has to be executed, and then break, and next case. How many you need, you can give. There is no limit here in this switch case, right? So you can give, and then at last you have to give default. That means if Here we have given label case label 1, label 2, label 3 like this. If this is not in the if we have to give an input, right? Here if you are not giving this 1, 2, 3, if other than this if you give any input, then this default, the code to be executed, if get this last line will be displayed. Understood? For a simple example, I'll say switch and days you are giving. Switch of days. Case 1. In this year, we can give Monday, break. Case 2, Tuesday, break. Case 3, Wednesday, break. And default, not a day. Likewise, if you are giving, in the output side, if you are giving 1, it will display as Monday. If you are giving 2, it will display as Tuesday. We have 7 days, so we will have given 7 days, right? If you are giving 0, or if you are giving 8, 9, or some other number other than 1 to 7, it will display as not a day. Whatever statement you are giving in the default section will be displayed here in this when you type 8 or some numbers other than 1 to 7. Clear? In the book, they have given this example. First, they have opened the PHP tag, and then this whatever you are giving this favorite color red. Here they have given a name, and that name you have to give inside this switch. Okay. Inside the switch statement, you have to give the name, and they have given us red. And first one case red. Next case is case blue. Next case is case green. For red, they have given the echoes. Your favorite color is red. And break. Break is that case is completed. Next one case blue. And in that line, they have given your favorite color is blue. And that case is also completed. So next one break. Then next one green, they have given the same way. And default. Default means if our input is not red, blue or green, this will be displayed. Echo, your favorite color is neither red, blue nor green. Likewise, the output will be displayed. Okay. The main thing here, and in every if statement, if else statement, is we have to open and close the brackets correctly. Okay. Here in switch case, first you will give switch off. In the inside the bracket, you will give the name, right? After that, you have to open the open parenthesis. And at last, after giving the default statement, you have to close the close parenthesis. And then you will close the PHP code, okay? First, you will open the PHP code with greater than symbol, question mark, PHP, right? And how will you close it? Again, question mark and first you will open with less than symbol, question mark, PHP, and in the last closing tag of PHP you have learned in the last session itself, question mark and greater than symbol, right? So that's all in this lesson. We'll just have a recap of it. We have seen the conditional statements, right? Conditional statements are if statement, if else statement, if else statement, and switch statement, right? If statement means it has a condition and a statement. If the condition is true, then the statement will be displayed or the set of codes will be executed. Here in this syntax, if you see if, then the condition will be there. And if you are giving the bracket only, inside that you can give a statement, right? Here only one set of statement will be there. So it's not an issue. But the correct syntax, the proper syntax is if, then the condition will be mentioned inside the bracket, and then the open parenthesis and close parenthesis inside that will give the statement or the set of codes which has to be executed if the statement is true, right? And the next one is if else statement. If else statement means in the same way, if will have if and then the condition inside a normal bracket, and then the open parenthesis. Then first set of statement, if the condition is true, that set of statement will be executed or that set of statement will be displayed, right? And then the parenthesis will be closed, and then the else section also same way, else open parenthesis and the statement which has to be executed when the condition is false, and then the bracket will be closed. Understood? If else, if is easy, just it will have only one set of statements. If else means for true, you'll have one set of statement. If the condition is false, we'll have another set of statement. If else means we can have multiple conditions, right? If one condition, if the condition is true, one statement that will be inside a particular parenthesis. Parenthesis is nothing but flower bracket. Okay, here else if, and we can give another condition, and if it is true, we can give the another statement for that separate condition. And likewise, you can give another how many else if you need, you can give. Okay. Else if, next condition, then next statement. Else if, next condition, and next statement. Likewise, you can give all the conditions, and at last you have to give else and then the statement. If all the other conditions are false, then the last else part will be executed, and whatever is inside the else part will be displayed. Okay, this else part also will be inside else part will have a statement, right? This statement or a set of quotes will be inside the open parenthesis and close parenthesis. Okay, and the next last we have seen about switch statement. Switch case means it is the alternative to this if else statement only. The same way there we are giving else if, here inside the switch will give first case 1, case 2, case 3. Inside each case, each statement or a set of code will be there. Each case will end with break. Okay, the last in the if else if we used else. Likewise, in switch case we have default. Okay, in this default section we can give a statement or we'll give a code which has to be executed. If the input which we give in the result section is not in this case, the thing which you give in the default section will be displayed. Understood? If you are giving case 1, case 2, case 3, means if you are giving some other numbers or some other letters or some other thing other than this 1, 2, 3, then the statement or the code which you have given in this default section will be executed. Okay? Clear? Are you clear? You have seen the conditional PHP conditional statements in this lesson. This is a very small lesson, PHP conditional statements. Learn this today itself. Just one, if you are learning one question, this whole lesson is completed, right? So this is a very very easy lesson, and you can learn it today within 10 minutes itself, right? And try to read the questions which is given after this chapter, and try to mark the answers also. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can text in our group or you can call me also. Okay, tomorrow we'll start with the looping structure chapter. Okay, thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.